Hello, everybody. Every intro is going to be different from now on because I can never decide what to say or what to do to start a video. I honestly just really want to do my makeup. I have a few new items that are new to me and some that I've kind of worked with a little bit. And I really wanted to just do my makeup with them and try some stuff out and talk to you guys and show you what I'm doing. So I'm doing this on my phone today just because I really want to just get going, get into it, and do my makeup, make it super easy because I'm craving to do a look on my face today. Okay, looking at myself in the mirror, let's get started. We're gonna look amazing. Okay, where do I want to start? To start, I recently got this from a little YSL Beauty launch party, which sounds really fancy, and I feel really luxurious, or I felt really luxurious being there. It was really cool. But they gave out a few products. This is one of them, the Touche Éclat All-in-One Glow. I like it with a beauty blender, or even better, this Real Techniques. Buffer brush? No, it's the Expert Face Brush. And I really like it like that, and you really don't need a lot. Should I prime my face? Do we want to prime? I feel like my skin's looking good enough. I don't want to prime. Too lazy. I have this idea, but I think it might need to pass because I have this that I want to use. It's a Milk Makeup Tattoo Stamp, and I got it in the peace, you can't see it, the peace sign, the sun. Anyways, it's the peace sign shape. It looks like it is, it looks like a little stamp. And I'm excited to use that. I think I'm gonna do like a little stamp underneath my eyes, or maybe on the side somewhere. Not sure yet. But before I do that, what do I wanna do? I'm gonna just mix these two shades. I can't tell you what they are, I always forget. I think this is Taco. This is called maybe Butter Cupcake or something. No, Butter Cupcake's the yellow, fuck. Sugar Cookie. I think it's called Sugar Cookie and the white is Taco. Just set whatever's on there so it doesn't get all creasy. I just kind of brightened it up too. I'm gonna put that powder down and I'm gonna grab just like a warm brown, maybe. I have this little, I think it's a ColourPop shadow, but it's one of their pressed. It is their pressed powder eyeshadow in Silver Lining, and it's just a really pretty purple. Let's start with the M518, and then we'll see if we need something. I'm just putting it in the crease, not even in the outer V, just in the crease, just like a pop of color. Yeah, I think this is super pretty, kind of like modern day Ursula, although she was purple and had green eyeshadow, I think. Either way, who doesn't want to feel like Ursula? As evil as she was a queen. She is a queen. And just to make that a little bit more, make that line sharper, I'm gonna go back in with the white. Next, what do I want to do? How would that look? It would be exciting, but I don't know if I love it. I'm gonna think about it. Until I do think about it, I do want to let you know what this is. This is another gift from the YSL party. It is their Mascara Vinyl Couture. I think the color 5, it's the blue one. I'm pretty sure they only have one blue one. I think I'm gonna go in and powder my face because I'm really excited about this product. It's very new to me. It's like a very new product on the market to begin with. And I really wanted it for a while. Once I heard about it, I was super excited about trying it. It's from Becca, It is their Hydra Mist Set and Refresh Powder. Pretty much it's supposed to be a powder that is like 80% water or something like that. It's so supposed to be really hydrating and not drying at all. So you open it and it's got this little thing. It says, keep me closed, or keep me closed to keep me cool. And there's just like a little pop-up. Of course, there's like a little sticker. Oh my God. And I'm gonna just go in and do it. Ooh, it's got a really bouncy sifter. Usually they're tight or plastic. That one's really bad. Oh, whoa. It feels wet. It's like really cooling. It feels wet. What? That's a freaky feeling. It's so cold. It feels wet. And yeah, it set my skin. I'm like shine free and it looks really natural. Wow, okay. I'm gonna do my brows now. This is another new product I'm very excited about. It is from Milk. It is their gel brow. And I got it in, what is this, Pale Ale. I really like brow pencils right now. They're a lot more handy. They're great for traveling because you don't need a brush. I'm usually a pomade girl, or I used to be, because I really liked Instagram brows for a while. And now I'm just kind of like, depends on the look, what kind of eyebrows I want to do, and tried it on my hand yet. Yeah, let's do that. See what the texture is like. Okay, so it's a pretty hard pencil, which I like because then you can get a really natural finish. Yeah, let's go for it. There's a brush on one end. I love a little spoolie. Already, it feels like it's very waxy, so it's sticking my hairs down a little bit more. Let's do some bronzer. This is an old product. I love this shit. It's one of my faves. I'm gonna just use Morphe M500, and this is a Becca palette. And the Sun Chaser palette. Just do it kind of on the points I would naturally get sun kiss, I guess. Do I want a contour? I don't want a contour. Do we want a blush today? This is my go-to blush, but I don't even know if I want to do that today. I'm feeling really spicy. Again, the Anastasia Amrazy highlighter. I'm so excited. It says an illuminating powder with an ultra smooth formula and radiant finish. Let's fucking do this. Oh my God. This is the Morphe M510. It's like the perfect highlighting brush. Oh. I hate being that girl that loves highlighter because everyone loves highlighter, but how can you not? Just seeing how it reacts in the sun, it's so beautiful. I use that pretty much all over my face, but there's this other product I recently got, and oh my God, I don't know how much this is, but it's worth all the money. It is by Youngblood, which is an all vegan, cruelty free brand that I personally really love. They're from Simi Valley, California. They're amazing. And this is called their Dusk Lunar Dust. And it's pretty much a loose highlighter. It's so fucking gorgeous. Tapped it out. I'll just wipe it on my hand so you can see. Oh my God. It's so intense. And it's so beautiful. So I'm gonna put that on my inner corner. The rest and put it on my ears. I love having a little bit of highlight on the tips of my ears. I think it's really sexy. Shh, don't tell anyone, but I think it's really sexy. Okay, we're gonna move on to a part I'm really excited about. All of these parts I'm super excited about. We're gonna do the tattoo stamp. They have a bunch of different shapes. I think I'm gonna get them all. I'm not insane. It's happening. I'm gonna get them all. I've decided. You know what? Let's do the bottom blue mascara. Let's have some fun today. Yeah. The brush is really big, which I'm usually not a fan of. It smells like perfume. It smells really like chemically, which worries me around the eyes. But I did wear this at Coachella all day and it stayed really well throughout sweating and wearing lots of sunscreen, which tends to be very oily and break down mascara, so it stayed really well. So if that's important to you more than the scent, then I would recommend it to you. Okay. And then I think the last little piece I'm gonna do, don't wanna line my lips. I'm gonna line my bottom lip, which sounds really weird, but I feel like it helps the shape of my lips out a little bit, and they look fuller if I just line the bottom one. So this is also kind of a new product. I've used it once now. It is the Youngblood Lip Liner Pencil in Au Naturel. Au Naturel. It's really browny, a browny pink. So it's good for contouring your lips. So I kind of just contoured my lips while it looks crazy in the camera. I promise it's not that crazy in real life, and it won't stay that way because I'm about to put something I'm really excited to use. God, how many times do I have to say that? It is the Fenty Beauty Lipstick in Single. Wow, the light in my mirror keeps reflecting weird shit on my face. Sorry. This is a really quick DIY video. Okay, what else should we do? There is that it. Are we done? Does this look complete? I am going to do one last thing because I wouldn't be a beauty guru unless I did this. I have my fan ready. This is my fan. It's a little thing from Amoeba that they gave us when we played in their San Francisco location. Was in their goodie bag, and it really has gotten a lot of use. And to set my face, I'm gonna use the Kat Von D Lock It Makeup Setting Mist. I think it's one of the best, and the mister on it's really great. Of course, I love the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist, but I think it's overpriced for how much product you get. This one has lasted a long time and was about the same price, so. That is it now. I'm gonna go probably lay on my bed and watch YouTube videos. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys follow me on Instagram and on Twitter, and you subscribe to this channel and you like my videos and you watch them and you stick around for more. You comment. Tell me what you wanna watch. Tell me what you want me to make. I'll try to do stuff on the road too. If you guys wanna watch like vloggy style videos of while I'm on tour, please let me know if that's something you're interested in. We do it on the Regrets YouTube channel, so check that out if you want all of our opinions and all of our stories and everything we're all doing. But I'd love to do something specific to this channel too, if that's something you're interested in. Maybe I'll do like a vegan food tour vlog. If that's interesting, let me know. I'll try to make some more videos very soon and upload as frequently as possible. Goodbye.